All right, good evening. This is sort of an interesting section of the program. We have so many awesome players that wanted to really do some chamber music, so we allotted some space for them. So we have three chamber groups. The first group is going to be conducted by George Cornelius. He teaches here at Allen High School. He teaches all the theory classes, music theory classes, AP music theory, IB music, and he's going to be doing one of his pieces. So please introduce Mr. George Cornelius and our trombone quintet.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Lance Alston. I wanted to thank everybody again for coming out tonight. Like we said, we are the AHS Trombone Choir. This group started about 2 years ago for a solo and ensemble contest, and a couple of us were part of that back then. We decided to keep it going throughout COVID and just keep practicing. And this year we decided to add new members to the trombone choir, the Wind Symphony Trombones, the second band. And I'm proud to say how much they've grown as players this year and just how much they've developed. And I just want to give a round of applause to them real quick. This next piece we're playing is called Excursions by David Wilborn. Some of us have been looking for this at this piece for about a year and a half, and some of us have just picked it up a couple months ago. And just the ability of these players to put this really challenging piece together is just phenomenal. So we're going to be playing Movements 2 and 3 tonight. I hope you guys enjoy it.
Good evening. For the second part of the Chamber Ensemble's concert, we have the Allen High School Saxophone Ensemble and with percussion as well. If you haven't heard the news, this ensemble was one of three Allen ensembles to receive an invitation to the International Midwest Orchestra and Band Conference that happens in Chicago in December. What you may not know about this as well is that there are a certain number of chamber wind groups that are invited to this conference, and the group in front of you on stage was one of only three ensembles from across the country to be invited to the Chicago Conference for Chamber Winds. So tonight we will be playing one of the pieces that we recorded for our submission. It's entitled Dancing Fire by Kevin Day. We hope you enjoy. Thank you. Good evening. I want to talk to you for just a second about the group of students that are in front of you right now. For the most part, with very few exceptions, these students are not freshmen, but most of them were in the freshman wind ensemble at one point. And a good majority of them are in the junior class, which 2 years ago, we didn't get to do a spring concert. So when some of these students approached me earlier this year and asked me to conduct them on the spring concert, I'm just extremely honored that they asked me to do that. And I'd like to give some gratitude to Zach Rankema, who put this group together. So if you'll help me give applause to Zach Rankema. The work that you're about to hear by Italian romantic composer Ottorino Respighi, if you're not familiar with The Pines of Rome, I just want to say a couple words about it. The Pines of Rome is a tone poem, which a tone poem is something that is programmatic. It has a story that is built into it. It's supposed to create imagery in your mind. And often composers will include a description or a program of some sort. And so Respighi has done that with this movement. So about the fourth movement, Respighi writes, "Misty dawn on the Appian Way. Solitary pine trees guarding the magic landscape, the muffled, ceaseless rhythm of unending footsteps. The poet has a fantastic vision of bygone glories, trumpets sound, and in the brilliance of the newly risen sun, a consular army bursts forth towards the sacred way, mounting a triumph to the capital." This work is probably the most appropriate work I can think of to bring in summer, because it's exactly what I'm feeling right now. So I hope you enjoy The Pines of the Appian Way.